probability of getting 4 and a single throw of a dice. Dice will have how many numbers? Getting 4 is one possibility out of 6. Probability of getting a card of spades. That is shape, right? How many possibilities are there? 13 out of 52 cards, which is 1/4. So 1/4 is more than 1/6. Answer. First option, Q1 less than Q2. Next. So need not to calculate, basically just observe the values. You have 15 here and 15 here. After that, two zeros, forget about it. Remaining numbers, 40 how many times? First case, 40 how many times? 30 times. 40 how many times? Which is more? Q2 is more than Q1. Done? Next. Circumference of a circle with radius 28. R is equal to 28. Circumference 2 pi r. 2 22/7 into 28. Don't calculate it, keep it like that. Next, perimeter of a square with side 38. That is 4 times of 38. Now do it. 7 how many times? 4 how many times? 44 times. But here 38 times. So Q1 more than Q2. 44 times is more than 38 times. Did you understand why I asked you not to calculate it? After that, when you have both the numbers, it becomes easy to relate and decide whether first is more or second is more. Next, take the first one. 14x is equal to 182. Come on. X is equal to 14x is equal to 182, then x is equal to 13. X is equal to 13. Suppose if y is also 13, substitute. 13 threes minus 10, but right hand side you have 41. That means y should be more than 13. Y greater than x. Q2 more than Q1. Followed? Need not to calculate y value and then decide. Just by comparison also you can do it. Can you do it? First one is x plus 15 whole square. Yes. Second one you need to calculate. X is negative number. Minus 15. Yes. And 300. 15? 20 times. Correct. So 3y square plus 15y plus 20y plus 100 is equal to 0. That means 3y into y plus 3, y plus 5. And then you need to take 20 common. Again you will get y plus 5. That means y is equal to minus 5 and also minus 20/3. Minus 20/3 and 5. X is equal to minus 15. Come on. Y greater than X in both the cases. Need to compare minus 15, minus 5. Minus 5 is more. Again need to compare minus 15 and minus 20/3. Minus 20/3 in the sense that is approximately minus 7. Minus 7 is more than minus 20. Number of degrees covered by hours hand of a clock in 2 hours. Hours hand. Clock is divided into how many hours? 12 hours is equal to 360 degrees. Then 1 hour? 30 degrees. Then 2 hour space? 60 degrees. Got it? Yes? Next. So Q1 is equal to 60. Number of degrees covered by minutes and of a clock in 15 minutes. 15 minutes in the sense, this part only, right? Yes or no? How much is this? And earlier we got? Q1 less than Q2. See, total clock, 360 degrees is divided into 60 minute space. 60 minutes is equal to 360. 1 minute is equal to? Matladaru. 6 degrees. 15 minutes is equal to 90 degrees. Need not to go for this calculation because you know that 15 minute space in the sense, this one, which is 90. 2 hours space in the sense, this one. Correct? 2 hour space. If it is 12, it is about 2. And you have 3 is here. 2 hour space in the sense, this part, which is 60. Next. Come on, 42. Total time taken by the boat to go 110 kilometers downstream and then return to its starting point is 120 hours. That means 110 kilometers traveled in downstream and 110 kilometers traveled in upstream and the total time is equal to 120 hours. And denominator you should write upstream speed and downstream speed. Now, speed of the boat in still water is 6. That means 6 plus S should come here and 6 minus S should come here. What is the speed of the stream? Now, instead of going for simplification, better to verify. Yes? 6 plus S, 6 minus S. Both should be factors of 110? Yes or no? If you write 2, 6 plus 2 in the sense 8, is 8 factor of 110? No. 6 plus 4, take second option, 10. Is 10 factor? Right. 110 by 10 will give you 11. 6 minus 4, 2. 110 by 2? 55. And then you already have 11. Is that equal to right hand side number 120? No. If it is 6, take second part, 6 minus 6, that becomes 0, which cannot be possible. Denominator can never be 0. Am I right? Now, fourth option, 6 plus 3, 9. Is 9 factor of 110? Fifth option, final answer. 6 plus 5? 110 by 11? 10. 6 minus 5? 1. 110 by 1? 110. 110 plus 10? 110 plus 11? 110 plus 10? 120. Satisfied? A alone can complete a piece of work in 48 days. B alone can complete it in 72 days. A, B, C all together can do it in 24 days. What will be C's per day payment if he is paid 72,000 to complete the entire work alone? Right. Now, let's go for LCM. This is A's work, B's work, and this is all together can complete work in 24 days, which includes A, B, C. Now, LCM, 144, 48 how many times? 48, 3 times. So, 3 units can be done by A. And B can complete? 2 units. All can complete 144 units in 24 days, that means 6 units. That means C alone can complete 1 unit because A, B, C all together work is equal to 6 units. So if C can complete 1 unit in 1 day, to complete total work, C need 144 days. Yes or no? And then C gets 1/6 of 72,000 because they will share 72,000 rupees according to their that 72,000 is for only C, correct, right. C is getting 72,000 rupees and working for 144 rupees, 144 days. Per day work in the sense 72,000 by 144. Cancellation with 144? 5 times is 720 and then 00. 500 answer. Is it clear? Next. Mona invested certain sum at 20% per annum compound interest for 2 years. Mohit invested the same sum as Mona at 10% per annum compound interest for 2 years. Right, so both are investing same principle. Amounts are same, principles are same. And both are compound interest only, but rate of interest are different. In first case, that is being given at 20% per annum, so for 2 years, 44%. And second case, 10% per annum, 21%. Right. And received interest of 23,200 less than Mona. In terms of percentage, how much percent less we got? If 23% is equal to 2300, what is the sum invested by Mona? Investment was 100%. That is equal to 10,000. Fifth option. Distance between Suresh office and home is 84 km. If he drives at 70 km per hour, he reaches 15 minutes later than the usual time. Find his speed on the next day if he reaches 15 minutes earlier than usual time. Now, to cover 84 km with the speed 70 km per hour, in 1 hour he can cover 70 km. Still, how many extra kilometers we have? 14. To cover 14 kilometers at the rate of 70 kilometers per hour, it takes 20% of 1 hour time. 20% of 1 hour in the sense 12 minutes. Earlier, 1 hour, that means 60 minutes. Plus 12 minutes, total 72 minutes. Yes or no? So, with the speed 70 kilometers per hour, it takes 72 minutes. Which includes 15 minutes late time, right? Yes or no? So actual time is 72 minus 15. This is the actual time. Including 15 minutes late, it is taking 72 minutes. So to get actual time, you need to subtract that extra time, 15 minutes. Are you getting my point? And now in second case, you are asked to calculate speed where he need to reach destination 15 minutes earlier than usual time. Usual time is 72 minus 15. Again, you need to subtract 15 minutes. Correct. So how much time we have now? 42 minutes. With 70 kilometers per hour, if it takes 72 minutes, how much speed we have to maintain where we have 42 minutes time? 10 times, 7, 6 times, 6, 12 times, 12 into 10, 120. I'm just taking distance in both the cases are equal. Is it clear, everybody? How are we getting 72? How are we getting 72? 84 kilometers is covered with 70 kilometers per hour, that is time. Time in minutes, hours to minutes, conversion into 60. 00 cancel, 7 12 times, 12 into 6, 72. But I am not doing that. I want to have 84. If I move with 70 kilometers per hour, in 1 hour, that means in 60 minutes I can cover 70 kilometers. Still, you have 14. 14 is 20% of this, so it takes 20% of 60 minutes, that is 12 minutes, total 72 minutes. Right, next. Approximations. Come on. 13 square, 169 plus 3 cube, 27. Next, 7 square, minus 7 square. Subtract 49 from this, you'll have 120 here and 27 already. Right? And under root 121? 11. And you have right hand side, minus 10, take that to left hand side, that becomes plus 10. So that becomes 11 becomes 21. So how much is the total? 168. What is this? 16. What is this? And then 16 plus 6, 22. 22 plus 23, 45. 45 is equal to which number multiplied by, what is this value? How much, how many times? Option? Answer 5, option 4. Be careful. ఆ స్పీడ్లో టక్కన వెళ్ళిపోద్ది చెయ్యి ఎక్కడికి ఫైవ్ దగ్గరికి వెళ్ళిపోతాం వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ 21 టైమ్స్ 288 డివైడెడ్ బై 12 12 టూ టైమ్స్ 24 అగైన్ ఫోర్ టైమ్స్ టోటల్ 45 ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు విచ్ నెంబర్ మల్టిప్లైడ్ బై cube root of 124 approximate 5. How many times? 9 times. What is this 4 square? 16 plus 8? 24 minus 26? Minus 2. Take minus 2 to right hand side becomes plus 2. You already have 2 in right hand side. Now 8 square? 64 minus 2 square. Subtract 4 from 64, 60 plus 2, 62. 5 square, you need to first complete number inside bracket, Bodmer's rule, braces you need to complete first, yes or no? Right, 5 square, 25 minus 18, 7, what is denominator? 7 how many times? 2 times, what is numerator? 38 by 2? 19. So, x square minus 19 we have. Take minus 19 to right hand side, that becomes plus 19. And can you write this number as 930 by 2? 930 by 2 in the sense half. How much? 465. Take this number as 20. 484. X square is equal to 484. X is equal to 22 square. You want this? Come on. Anybody? In 2017, out of number of exhibitions organized by company B, 3/8 were textile exhibitions, and out of number of exhibitions organized by company C, 4/9 were textile exhibitions. What is the difference between number of textile exhibitions organized by company B in 2017 and that by company C in the same year, B and C, 2017 diamond, company B value in diamond, how much is this? 480 and company C 360, one is 480, other is 360. Company B textile, how many are textile? 3/8. So we need to calculate 3/8 of this number. And in company C, textile are what fractional part? 4/9. 4/9. Were you asked about difference or sum? Difference. So let's individually calculate both the numbers. 8 how many times? 63's? 180. 9 how many times? 44's? Difference? Over. What is there? Don't get confused. క్వశ్చన్ పెద్దగా ఉందని భయపడద్దు, ఏముంది, ఏం లేదు, చదివితే అర్థమైపోద్ది. ఇఫ్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ ద క్వశ్చన్ దట్ బికమ్స్ 50% ఈజీ. ఓకే, కన్ఫ్యూజ్ అవ్వద్దు, టెన్షన్ పడద్దు. టెన్షన్ పడితే ఏమొస్తుంది? టెన్షన్ వస్తుంది. ఎస్ఆర్ నో? క్వశ్చన్ సాల్వ్ చేయడం వీలవుతుంది ఆ టైంలో? డూ. ఉద్యోగం వస్తే మంచిది, రాకపోతే ఏ లెక్కన మరీ మంచిది చెప్పండి, లాజిక్ చెప్పండి అమ్మా. మోర్ ఆపర్చునిటీసా? ఎట్లా? अंटे जस्ट स्टेटमेंट आई डोंट वांट टू से मीक नच्चुतदि कदा अनि चेप्पेसि एदो मीक मंचि माट नच्चेलागा ओक माट चेप्पडं नाकु इष्टं लेदु दिस इज लॉजिकली प्रूवन మీరు రాసే ఎగ్జామ్లో మీకు ఉద్యోగం వస్తే మంచిది, రాకపోతే మరీ మంచిది. లాజికలీ ట్రూ. టెల్ మీ హౌ. నెక్స్ట్ టైంలో ఇంకా మోర్ నాలెడ్జ్ వస్తుంది కాబట్టి నెక్స్ట్ టైంకి ఈ మధ్య గ్యాప్లో రెండు అమ్మా మోర్ ఎఫెక్ట్స్ పెడతాము. డిమోటివేట్ అయ్యి ఫ్యాన్కి వైపు చూస్తే ఆ బ్యాచ్ కూడా ఉన్నారు కదా, అంటే మనం అందరి గురించి ఆలోచించాలి. అవునా? సో లాజికల్లీ ప్రూవెన్ నేనేంటంటే రెండు పాయింట్లు చెప్తా. ఫస్ట్ పాయింట్ ఏంటంటే ఇందులో వస్తే మంచిది, రాకపోతే మరీ మంచిది అని ఎందుకు అనుకోవాలంటే మేబీ సమ్ అదర్ బెటర్ ఆపర్చునిటీ ఈజ్ వెయిటింగ్. ఇప్పుడు వస్తే దీనిలోనే ఫిక్స్ అయిపోతామేమో. ఎస్ ఆర్ నో? ఇంకా మంచిది వస్తుందేమో అనే పాజిటివ్ యాటిట్యూడ్ తోటి ఉండాలి. ఆప్టిమిస్టిక్, ఆప్టిమిస్టిక్. రెండో పాయింట్, ఇది లాజికల్లీ ట్రూ. ఎట్లా అంటే ఫస్ట్ థింగ్ యూ షుడ్ అగ్రీ, ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ సెలెక్టెడ్ దెర్ ఆర్ పీపుల్ హూ ఆల్రెడీ గాట్ జాబ్స్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ నోటిఫికేషన్. మీకు రాలేదంటే మీ ఇచ్చిన వాళ్ళంతా ఉన్నారు, వాళ్ళంతా మీకంటే బెటర్గా పర్ఫామ్ చేశారు. ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ యూ షుడ్ యాక్సెప్ట్ దట్, రైట్? వాళ్ళు మీకంటే తెలివిగల వాళ్ళు మీకంటే బెటర్గా పెర్ఫామ్ చేశారు. వాళ్ళు పెర్ఫామ్ చేసిన క్వాలిటీ ఏంటి, మన దగ్గర లేనిది ఏంటి? ఫస్ట్ యూ షుడ్ ఐడెంటిఫై అండ్ యూ షుడ్ డెవలప్ ఇట్. రెండోది దీనిలోనే, ఇప్పుడు మీకంటే బెటర్గా పర్ఫామ్ చేసేవాడు మీతో పాటు ఉంటా ఉన్నాడు, మీతో పాటు ఎగ్జామ్ రాస్తూ ఉన్నాడు అంటే వాడు ఎప్పటికైనా మీకు కాంపిటీటరే. అది డేంజరస్ ఫెలో. ఎస్ ఆర్ నో? ఈ నోటిఫికేషన్ తోటి వాడు వెళ్ళిపోయాడు, సో వాడు మీకు నెక్స్ట్ నోటిఫికేషన్స్లో అడ్డు కాదు. నెక్స్ట్ టైం మీరే ముందు రేస్లో ఉంటారు. అర్థమైందా? కాంపిటీషన్ తగ్గిపోతుంది అక్కడ. మీ ముందు వరుసలో మీకంటే తెలివిగళ్ళు ఎవరైతే ఉన్నారో వాళ్ళందరికీ ఈ ఎగ్జామ్లో ఉద్యోగాలు వచ్చేసి పక్కకి వెళ్ళిపోతే వాళ్ళున్నంత వరకు మీకు రాదు, వాళ్ళు మీకంటే ముందున్నారు కాబట్టి. ఎమ్ఆర్ఐ వాళ్ళు సైడ్ అయిపోతే లైన్ క్లియర్ అయింది కదా. నెక్స్ట్ టైంకి ఖర్చీఫ్ మందే. నెక్స్ట్ టైం అది ఖర్చీఫా, టవలా, దుప్పటా, రగ్గా అనేది మీ చేతుల్లో ఉంది. ఎస్, లాజికల్లీ ట్రూ ఆర్ నాట్? ఎస్ ఆర్ నో? సో జోగం రావటం ఇంపార్టెంటే. రాలేదు అని అంటే ఇంకా మంచిది అని అనుకోవాలి. కమాన్, ఎనీ అదర్ క్వశ్చన్ ఇన్ దిస్ సెట్? మాట్లాడిచవరు మీ పాడే మీరు. కమాన్, దిస్ వన్. అమ్మా 55? ఓకే. కంపెనీ ఎఫ్ కుడ్ ఆర్గనైజ్ ఓన్లీ 80% ఆఫ్ ది ఆర్డర్స్ రిక్వెస్ట్ ది రిసీవ్ ఫర్ 2017 డ్యూ టు టైమ్ కన్స్ట్రెయిన్ట్. ఇఫ్ కంపెనీ ఏ ఆల్సో రిసీవ్ ద సేమ్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్డర్స్ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఇన్ 2017 యాజ్ కంపెనీ ఎఫ్, దెన్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద అప్రాక్సిమేట్ పర్సంటేజ్ ఆఫ్ కంపెనీ ఏ ఆల్సో రిసీవ్ ద సేమ్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్డర్ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఇన్ 2017 యాజ్ కంపెనీ ఎఫ్? ఓకే. Then what is the approximate percentage of orders company A managed to organize in 2017? Approximate increase, right? 2017, what is value of A? Come on, come on. 260. And in F, 580. 260, 580. You're asked about percentage increase of orders. Which question is this? 55. Company A in 2017 have how many orders? Come on, this one we already marked it. How much? So that means Company A can complete 260 orders. But if A receives number of order requests in 2017 as Company F, Company F has how many orders? 580. But out of 580, Company A can complete only 260 orders? Yes or no? So 260 as a percentage out of 580 into 100. What is 10% of denominator? 58. Double? 116. Again double? 232. So 40%. Kadamma, agandi chepta. No, right. I'll tell you. I'm right. 40% is equal to 232. Yes or no? Right. How much more we need to add to make it 260? 28. So, that is approximately what percent of this? 5%. What is 10% of denominator? 58. 5%? 29. Approximately? 5%. Answer should be approximate to? 45%. Which is right answer? First option. Now, 80%, first line. Undi kada 80% tisukovali ani antaru 580 lo. Antena? Yes or no? Right. Adi avasaram ledu. Adi unnecessary point. Meeku second line lo em icharu chudandi amma okkasari. If company A also receive same number of order requests, company F 2017 lo ఎన్ని ఆర్డర్ రిక్వెస్ట్స్ వచ్చినాయో అన్ని 2017లో ఏకి వస్తాయి అని అంటున్నారు. ఎఫ్కి వచ్చింది మొత్తం 580 ఆర్డర్స్. దానిలో ఎఫ్ ఎంత కంప్లీట్ చేస్తున్నారు అని అంటే 80%. ఇప్పుడు ఆర్డర్ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్, ఆర్డర్ కంప్లీషన్ ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్. ఎఫ్కి ఎన్ని వచ్చినాయి అన్నారు? ఎన్ని ఆర్డర్స్ ఎఫ్కి వచ్చినాయో అన్ని రావాలి అని అన్నారు. ఆర్డర్ రిక్వెస్ట్ ఫర్ కంపెనీ ఎఫ్ ఇన్ 2017 ఈజ్ 580. సో we don't need to bother how many of them are completed by F. So need not to consider first statement at all. Adi F complete chesina projects mana complete chesini avasaram la order request lo unnachini anne kavali. Okay na? Clear everybody? Right. Come on. The respective ratio between male and female students in BA in the year 2018 becomes 7:2 2018. Okay. Given data is for 2017. In 2018 becomes 7:3 and number of students in BA course increases to 300. Then what is the difference between number of male students in 2018 and in 2017 in the same course? Right. In 2018, male and female students in BA course together, how much? 300. That is divided into total how many parts? 10 parts. If 10 parts is equal to 300, each part is 30, then male are 7 parts, that is 210, and female are 90. Now your question is about only male or female? Difference between male students in 2018 and 17. So you need not to worry about female count? Yes or no? Right, come on. Now table information gives you about female student percentage. This is about BA course. BA, what percentage of total strength are female? 60%. Then 40% are male. 40% of what? 20%. What is 40% of 20? 40% of 20, 8. 8% of what? 500. What is 8% of 500? Come on. 40. What is difference? 170. Which option? Fifth option. Clear everybody? Next. Number of male students in BA is what percent more than number of female students of students in B form? Ippude kada BA students percentage lo maatladukunam. Enta? మాట్లాడాలి 8%. ఇప్పుడు బి ఫార్మాలో ఫీమేల్ కావాలి. బి ఫార్మా వాట్ ఈస్ ఫీమేల్ పర్సంటేజ్? 25% ఆఫ్ వాట్? వాట్ ఈస్ 25% ఆఫ్ 25? వాట్ పర్సన్ మోర్ దే ఆర్ సేయింగ్? 80 ఈజ్ హౌ మచ్ మోర్ దెన్ 5? 3 మోర్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 5. 3/5 ఇన్ ద సెన్స్ వాట్ పర్సంటేజ్? ఓవర్ 60%. 80 ఈజ్ 3 మోర్ దెన్ 5. 3/5 ఈజ్ 60%. ఇస్ ఇట్ క్లియర్? వాట్ ఈస్ యావరేజ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ మేల్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఇన్ బీకామ్ బీ ఫార్మా? బీ ఫార్మ్ ఇప్పుడే కదా ఫీమేల్ పర్సంటేజ్ మాట్లాడాం. హౌ మచ్ ఫీమేల్ ఇన్ బీ ఫార్మ్? 5. అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 20. అవుట్ ఆఫ్ 20 ఈ 5 ఆర్ ఫీమేల్, రిమైనింగ్ 15 ఆర్ మేల్. అండ్ ఇన్ బీకామ్ ఆల్సో వీ నీడ్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ బీకామ్ ఫీమేల్ పర్సంటేజ్ 50% ఆఫ్ 22, దట్ మీన్స్ 11. ఇఫ్ 11 ఆర్ ఫీమేల్ దెన్ 11 ఆర్ మేల్. సో టోటల్ మేల్ పర్సంటేజ్ ఇన్ బోత్ ద కోర్సెస్ టుగెదర్ ఈస్ 26%. ఎస్ ఆర్ నో? బట్ యూ ఆస్క్డ్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ యావరేజ్. యావరేజ్ ఇన్ ద సెన్స్ ఇట్ బికమ్స్ 13. ఎస్ ఆర్ నో? 13% ఆఫ్ వాట్? 500. 13/5 = 65, బికాస్ 1% ఈస్ 5, యు నో దట్. 13%, 13/5 = 65. క్లియర్? వాట్ ఈస్ ద టోటల్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఫీమేల్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఇన్ బీ ఫార్మ్ అండ్ బీఏ టుగెదర్? బీ ఫార్మ్ ఫీమేల్ పర్సంటేజ్, ఎస్, 5%. అండ్ ఇన్ బీఏ యు నో వాట్ ఈస్ మేల్ పర్సంటేజ్? 8%. ఫస్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ కదమ్మా. ఇఫ్ 8% ఆర్ మేల్ దెన్ 12% ఆర్ ఫీమేల్. టోటల్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఫీమేల్ ఇన్ బోత్ ద కోర్సెస్ టుగెదర్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ పర్సంటేజ్ 17%. యు నో 1% ఈస్ 5, 17/5 = 85. వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ మేల్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఇన్ బీటెక్ అండ్ ఫీమేల్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఇన్ బీఎస్సీ? బీటెక్ అండ్ బీఎస్సీ సో ఫార్ వీ హ్యావ్ నాట్ డన్ ఎనీ క్వశ్చన్, సో వీ హ్యావ్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ ఇట్ నౌ. బీటెక్ మేల్, ఇన్ బీటెక్ వాట్ ఈస్ ఫీమేల్ పర్సంటేజ్? 35. దెన్ 65% ఆర్ 65% ఆఫ్ దిస్ నెంబర్. డోంట్ క్యాలిక్యులేట్, లెట్ ఇట్ బి లైక్ దట్, డోంట్ క్యాలిక్యులేట్. నెక్స్ట్ ఫీమేల్ ఇన్ బీఎస్సీ, ఇన్ బీఎస్సీ ఫీమేల్ పర్సంటేజ్ 40% ఆఫ్ 22. సో ఎర్లియర్ వీ హ్యావ్ 16/65, నౌ యూ హ్యావ్ 40/22. ఎస్ ఆర్ నో? రైట్. నౌ పర్సంటేజ్ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేయాలి అపాన్ 500. డోంట్ డూ ఇట్. ఇది కాదు. సో లెట్స్ ట్రై టు డూ ఇట్. ఐ వాంట్ 16 times of 65. 65 10 times, 5 times 1 time. 65 10 times, 650. 5 times in the sense just half of it. Again, one more time. Total 325, 65. Last two numbers, 390. 390 and 650. 1040. Now, 40, 22 times. 880. What is difference? This is 120 less, the other one is 60 more. Difference? 160 by 100. Yes or no? ఇదంతా ఏంటి పర్సంటేజే కదా. ఆఫ్ 500. ఏదో తేడా వచ్చింది. రైట్. బోత్ ఆర్ పర్సంటేజెస్, 65% of 16%, 40% of 22%. ఎస్ ఆర్ నో? సో ఇన్ డినామినేటర్ యూ విల్ హ్యావ్ 200 అండ్ ఇన్ న్యూమరేటర్ యూ నీట్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ దిస్ పర్సంటేజ్ ఆన్ 500. 2 zeros క్యాన్సిల్, 0 క్యాన్సిల్, 5 2 times, 2 8 times. ఆన్సర్ 8. both are percentages. Hence, you have two symbols. When you delete two symbols, you need to write two hundreds in denominator. Next. Data is regarding number of temporary and permanent employees working in two organizations A and B. Note, 2y is equal to x, 2q is equal to p. Total number of employees is equal to number of temporary employees and number of permanent employees. Okay. Total number of permanent employees remains the same. Okay. HR department of two organizations A and B with a total 500 and 600 permanent and temporary respectively adopted a new strategy for maintaining their manpower. Okay. So total employees in A, organization A, total employees 500 and in B 600. So A and B, we will have permanent and temporary together will be equal to total. Yes or no? Total employees in A and B respectively are 500 and 600. That's what information so far that we have. Next. Number of permanent employees in organizations A and B are 5x and 8p respectively. Permanent employees 5x and 8p. Next. Number of temporary employees in organizations A and B are 10y and 4q. 10y and 4q. See, sum of these two is equal to 500. In organization A, both permanent employees and temporary employees together is equal to 500. Yes or no? And look at your note 1. What does note 1 says? 2y is equal to x. If x is equal to 2y, then 5x is equal to 10y. Permanent and temporary, both are 10y, 10y. That means equal. So that means 50%. 50% of what? 500. So 500 employees are equally divided in both permanent and temporary employees department. So each gets 250, 250. Got it? And look at note 2. 2q is equal to p. From that, can I take 4q as 2p? 8p plus 2p? 10p is equal to 600. Then p is equal to? Come on. 60. Then 8p, 8 into 60, 480. And remaining? 120. 120 are temporary. Getting my point? Right. So now you know both temporary and permanent employees in both organizations. Next. After 1 year, outcomes of new HR strategy were analyzed and it was found that number of temporary employees who got promotion in organization A and B were 20% and 30% respectively. Out of temporary employees, 20% and 30%. It is said that those who are not promoted left their jobs immediately. That means 80% from organization A, 70% from organization B immediately resigned for their jobs. Temporary employees were promoted to another temporary position and not to any permanent position. So promotees, 20% of A and 30% of B, were not promoted to permanent jobs. They were again promoted to one more level of temporary job. Okay? Right. So out of 250, only 20% were promoted. So next year, how many will be there? 50 will be there. Yes or no? Now, in organization B, how many were promoted? 30%. That means only 36 are there. Remaining people left their job. This happened after 1 year. After 1 year. Okay, now? Right. Come on. Any other information? No. That's it. Come on. After 2 years in organization A, if half of the permanent employees leave the organization, What is the total number of permanent employees in organization A and B together? During this year, there is no change in the strength of permanent employees of organization B. Right. Initially, what is permanent employees? How many permanent employees are there in organization A? And in B? After 1 year? After 1 year? No change. After 1 year? No change. After 2 years, 50% of number of employees in organization A left. Out of 250, 50% in the sense? 125 left. And in B, 480 remains same. But you are asked to calculate what? Total employees. Yes or no? Total permanent employees in organization A and B. In A we have only 125 and in B we have 480. What is total? 605. Clear? Next. Number of permanent employees in organization A is what percent of initial total number of employees in organization B? In organization B, how many employees are there? 600. And permanent employees in organization A are? Come on. 250 percentage, so into 100. Correct. What is 10% of denominator? 60. Approximately how many 60s are there in numerator? 4. 460 is 240. And still extra, how much you have? 10. So that means answer is more than 40%. Apart from 40%, you may be having 1% or 2% approximate. So answer should be nearby 41% or 42%. Is it done? Clear everybody? Next. What is the respective ratio of number of temporary employees who left their jobs in organization A to that those who left their jobs in organization B? From organization B, in organization B, how many temporary employees are there? 250. And in B, 120. See, out of 250, 20% left, then remaining will be 80% of 250. And in B, we have total 120 employees, temporary employees. Out of them, 30% left, then remaining 70%. 30% were promoted to next level. Then 70% left their job. And in organization A, 20% were promoted. Then who left are? 80%. 80% of 250, 70% of 110, 120. Are you getting my point? 42 times, 40, 3 times. Yes or no? Now, in numerator, do you have 3 multiple? But in denominator, we got 3 multiple. So, in your answer also, second number should be 3 multiple. Fourth option, final answer. Got it? If after 1 year, what is the difference between total number of employees in organization A and that in organization B? See, after 1 year, in organization A, permanent employees are 250. Yes or no? Out of temporary employees in that you have initially, 50 were promoted to next level. So total how much number we have? 300. Are you getting? And in B, already we have 480 permanent employees. And out of temporary employees, 36 were promoted. 480 plus 36? 516. So, in organization A, we have 300. And in B, we have 516. You're asked about difference. What is difference between both the numbers? 216. Yes. What is the initial difference between number of temporary employees in both the organization? Initially, how many temporary employees are there in A? And in B? Difference? 130. Fifth option. Okay?